you should get in. You're not gonna believe this, but I finally got a date with a guy from the lighthouse. You know the one with the incredible bulge in his pants? I can't believe it. I need to buy that sexy red dress of yours. I know my tits aren't as big as yours, but I'll still look hot. So give me a call right away, okay, Valerie? Thanks.
Hey, Valerie, how long is up? Babe, got the job. Tomorrow morning, you're on your way to Paris to shoot the cover of Cosmo. Hey, Valerie, hold on your socks, babe. You've got the job. Tomorrow morning, you're on your way to Paris to shoot the cover of Cosmopolitan. Look, I told him you have a great tan, so make sure you do. Ciao, babe.
Thank you. What's the hurry?
No, Tommy, I'm
looking
late.
Good.
Come on, Tommy, this isn't funny.
I just want to know one thing.
What?
What's the zipper for, baby?
Leave it to your imagination.
How about tonight?
No, Jimmy.
Well, how about tomorrow night?
Look, not tonight, not tomorrow night, not any night. How many times do I have to say that? Well, good afternoon.
I'm sorry I'm late, Rhonda. I got here as fast as I could.
In my office.
Rhonda?
In my office. Well, what's it gonna be this time?
I'm late and I'm sorry, okay?
No, that's not okay. I just had to spend my time teaching your class instead of doing my books. And then you show up 5 minutes after the class is over with? I don't think so.
I'm sorry, okay, Rhonda?
But Jamie, you can't keep doing this to me. This place is too damn important to me.
I said I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
I just had a really bad day. Why don't you just start locking up?
Got it. And I'm gonna take you to dinner, okay?
All right, now get out of here.
Show you what the zipper is really for. You meet the club at 10.
I'll be there. If you're lucky.
I'm always lucky.
Yeah.
I'll see you later.
Bye.
Thank you. with Jimmy, I don't even want to know. Why don't you just start closing up so we can go to that dinner, okay?
Okay.
What can you tell me about this Rachel McClee?
Oh, come on. We just spent the last 3 hours going over the same thing with some other cop.
I'm not some other cop. Name's Morgan, detective lieutenant in charge of this investigation. Get used to the name, you're gonna see a lot of me. And if we have to go over this for another 3 hours, that is precisely what we will do.
She was so pretty.
Not anymore. How well did you know her?
I didn't really. Like, she came in a couple times a week. We said hi and bye. That's about it.
Ever see that before?
Oh, is that what she was killed with?
Maybe. Tell me about Diane Matthews.
Why?
Because that was found in her locker. And so was the body, in case you didn't notice. Now tell me about her.
Oh, she's a good customer. She's been a customer for about a year. Quiet type. Never really had any problems with her.
I need more than that.
She's kind of shy, not really one of the crowd. A little jealous, too, I think.
Of what?
I'm not really sure, just not fitting in, I guess. I see her at a few local bars. She's always sitting by herself. Just kind of watching the rest of us.
I suppose this will all be over the news by morning.
Does that bother you?
Won't help business.
Business?
I'm a partner.
The other partner will have to be notified. going to be seeing a lot more of me.
I can hardly wait.
Yeah.
No shit. No shit. Happened right here last night.
Really?
Yeah, man. Some fucker cut her up in little pieces and stuffed her in a locker.
Did he screw her first?
I don't know, but I would have. She was a babe.
Yeah. It's almost 8:30. I better hit the showers. I'll be late for work again. Coming?
I ain't even breathing hard.
See you there.
Okay.
When you're close, it's the most satisfaction.
Five, ever kisses six, new. Seven, eight, one,
what we feel
two,
is a real
three,
love attraction.
Four, seven,
touching
one,
me, touching
two,
you.
Three, four, five,
we're making
six,
happen all
seven,
night
eight,
long.
Eight,
it's love
six,
in action.
Five,
doing? Look, business is bad enough already.
What?
Look, just teach the class to stop showing off your tits and tight little ass. Got it? You.
Hi, I'm Chuck Dawson. I was just, who are you?
Rhonda Johnson. I own this place. Find what you're looking for?
Huh? No, you see, you don't understand. There wasn't anybody around, and I just thought if I looked over things a little, you know, I could get a better feel about the place.
Better feel? Look, you want to feel, try Hollywood Boulevard. Now get the hell out of here.
That's good. That's really funny, but you don't understand. Okay, I start work here today.
No way.
Come on, this is no way to start an employer-employee relationship here. This is from your senior partner, Mr. Erickson. He hired me on yesterday.
What?
Everything a little clearer now?
Oh, yeah, it's clear all right.
Great, where do I start? I'm dying to get to work.
Men's toilet needs scrubbing.
Right.
Hey! What the hell's your problem, man? You almost ran into me.
Problem? I don't have any problem. You new around here?
Just started today. Who's asking?
Someone who's going to give you some real good advice.
Is that right?
That's right.
Well, I can hardly wait.
Stay away from Rhonda.
Get the hell out of here.
You don't listen very well, do you? Stay away from her. I'm going to take you apart, piece by piece.
You just made a mistake.
Come on.
Next time, I'm gonna finish it.
saw that, did you?
I saw enough of it.
Do we know each other?
I'm Debbie.
I'm Chuck.
Care to go for a ride?
Yeah, it's the best offer I've had all day.
Great. Hop in.
So, have you been a member of the workout for very long?
A little over a year or so.
So what do you know about this Jimmy Halleck?
I was stupid enough to go out with him a while back.
Why do you say that?
Because the guy is weird. I mean, he likes to tie girls up and do weird things. You know, I mean, it's cool to get kinky sometimes, but the guy's just plain weird.
You don't have his address, do you?
Why, are you gonna ask him out?
No, not quite. I just might pay him a visit later on today.
I'll go look for it. I wanted to go inside and change anyways. Now don't you go anywhere. I'll be right back. Watch your way!
Hey, Mr. Erickson, Chuck Dawson.
Yeah, I know all about that.
Nothing, I haven't had a chance yet, but I'm working on it.
Yeah, I know that's what I'm getting paid for.
Look, don't worry about it, okay? Look, I gotta go.
Right.
Here's Jimmy's address.
Oh, great, and thanks for the drink.
Oh, you're not gonna leave right now, are you?
I think I'd better. I gotta get back to the workout for a while. I got a lot to do.
Well, I think you got a lot to do right here.
Is that right?
Morgan to headquarters.
Go ahead, Lieutenant.
Get the report back from the lab on that knitting needle.
Not yet. Where are you?
Don't worry about where I am. Get over to the lab and tell that college boy. If he doesn't have that report in 30 minutes, I'm going to come over there and do an autopsy on his face. You got that?
Yes, sir. What is your look?
Do it!
Yes, sir.
Who's there?
Open up! Open the door! Open up! Open up the door, it's the police! Morgan, what is it?
Just got the report on the knitting needle belonging to Diane Matthews. It was not the murder weapon. I repeat, it was not the murder weapon.
Oh, shit.
Funny, Jimmy. Don't you ever do that to me again.
I wasn't trying to scare you.
You didn't scare me.
Hey, just relax. I'm not some kind of crazy killer.
Would you just stop it?
Look, I just wanted to see you alone.
Look, I know you're not a killer, Jimmy. But you are an asshole.
Shut up, you little cunt. What'd you have to bring her for?
Your page, remember?
Oh, yeah. It's all clear. Come on.
Not we, you. I'm going back to the car.
Curtis. Curtis, where are you?
See you later, Brad. So you just started working here yesterday, huh?
Yeah, that's right, Lieutenant.
Just a coincidence, I suppose, you got here in the middle of all this killing.
I suppose.
Why is it I don't believe you?
I don't know. I always thought I had an honest face.
You don't think it's because you laid this guy out like a pro, do you?
Nah, that was easy.
Right. I don't know what it is about you, but I'm gonna find out. You count on it.
It's okay, Tommy. It's okay.
Well, what's going on?
I want to show you what the zipper's really for.
Oh.
This...
For some time now.
It all happened so fast.
I suppose you don't remember being found in the same room with two dead men? Relax. We're not through with you. I'll be right back. And don't try anything stupid. There's an officer right outside the door.
Right.
See you tomorrow, Lieutenant.
Seems like things really picked up since you got here.
Yeah, it does look that way, doesn't it?
It's two of us. I just spoke to my senior partner. See, I was going to beg him to let me keep this place open. But he already wanted to sail. And I can't figure that out.
Must be a reason.
You know, I know damn well there's a reason. I just want to know what the hell it is.
You're pretty handy with that thing.
Look, where I am is pissed off. And I want some answers. I want to know what the hell you're doing about this, because I don't see you doing any more than standing around acting like some goddamn TV cop. Well, half of my customers are being killed off, and the other half are canceling their memberships.
May I? Very sharp.
Then you hardly have anything in common, do you?
I'm just doing my job, Miss Johnson.
Well, what exactly is your job, Lieutenant? Do you even have a suspect?
As a matter of fact, I have several. It's the motive I can't quite figure out, but I will. I will.
Are you sure?
Officer Peterson's gonna hang around for the rest of the evening, if you don't mind.
Fine.
Good, I'm running out of body bags.
Rhonda, are you okay?
Yes, Jimmy, I'm okay. Look, I'm also real busy. If you hadn't noticed, there's been a lot of trouble here.
I know. I can help, Rhonda.
I don't think so, Jimmy.
Check. check in every hour.
You got it, Lieutenant.
Oh,
Where is he?
I think I better ask the questions, Charlie. It is Charlie, isn't it?
Charlie Dawson, private investigator. You know, I knew there was something about you.
The Simpson case, wasn't it? 5-6 years ago?
It was closer to 7.
Look, what the hell's going on here?
You want to tell me about it here, Charlie, or do I put the bracelets on you?
He's gonna run and you're gonna lose him.
We'll catch him. Right now I want to hear the whole story. And I want to hear it straight.
Yeah, well, that makes two of us.
Well, I guess it's all over now, isn't it? Her partner flew me in from San Francisco the morning after the first girl got dusted. Just wanted me to check things out, that's all.
And did that include spying on me in the middle of the night?
I wasn't here to spy on you. I was here to save you.
Oh, right.
The guy Jimmy, I saw the way he looked at her in a spot. It was weird, you know? It was definitely not normal. A little bit later, I went through his locker. Came up with these.
Oh my God.
All you. Rhonda in a spa, Rhonda at home, Rhonda getting in her car, Rhonda walking across the street. All you.
He always bugged me trying to get me to go out with him, but I never thought it was like this.
Did you?
Huh?
Did you go out with him?
No, never.
Well, that's not all. Earlier this evening, I went over to his apartment and let myself in. Guess whose picture is plastered all over the walls?
Mine.
You got it.
What kind of pictures?
Just pictures. After that, I figured around it was next, so I came here.
And tomorrow you leave here, back to San Francisco. You got me.
Hey, he's all yours, Lieutenant. But you better get him. And you better get him now.
Finally doing your laundry, huh, Kathy?
I'm getting out of here while I'm still in one piece. If you had any brains, you would do the same thing.
Hey, I was just kidding.
Where's Jamie? I want to say goodbye to her.
She was here a minute ago. Try the aerobics room. Jamie? Jamie?
That's against the law, Dawson. I thought I told you to stay out of here.
Yeah, I'm leaving, Morgan, okay? I just came by to pick up a few things I left inside. Is that okay with you?
Why don't you try using the keys? This is Morgan.
I've got the report on Johnson.
Well?
I think you better come see this for yourself.
I'm on my way.
Lieutenant.
Miss Johnson.
Well, what is it this time, Lieutenant?
Have a seat, Valerie. Valerie Johnson. That is your real name.
It was. I changed it legally.
Uh-huh. You know, after last night, I was almost convinced that Jimmy Halleck was our man. Oh, he's nuts, all right. But the pieces, they just didn't fit together. The motives, they're all wrong. There are two common denominators in all the murders. All the victims were members of the spa. Number two is what I just couldn't figure out until today. All of them were good-looking, beautiful people, in great shape. Perfect bodies, one might say.
All except me.
All except you. Rhonda Johnson. Who used to be the perfectly beautiful Valerie Johnson. Until 70% of her body was burned in a tanning spa accident 5 years ago.
Look, that's enough!
Valerie Johnson, who was to become the modeling world's newest young star, but suddenly couldn't get a job starring in a freak show.
What do you want, Morgan? What? Look, is this what you wanted to see? Is that it?
That's not necessary.
Found out my terrible secret. So what? That doesn't mean I killed those people.
I think it does. I think it eats you up inside to look at all those young, beautiful bodies, knowing that you have to spend a lifetime hiding yours, knowing that any man would get sick if he tried to make love to you.
You bastard.
Just doing my job.
Can't ever prove I did anything. Because I didn't.
What is it now?
Chuck Dawson's dead. Same M.O. Body's cut the ribbon.
When?
It was Jimmy Halleck, all right. We've got two witnesses and we've got the weapon. He's still loose, though. I just put out an all points on him. Lieutenant? Lieutenant, are you there? Come in, Lieutenant. Lieutenant Morgan.
Now. She did it all, didn't she? Didn't she?
Morgan.
That's right, Miss Johnson. It's a rental.
I don't understand. I was about to meet someone for lunch, and then you show up and pull me away on what you call urgent police business?
Just shut up and get out of the car.
Morgan. It's taking walks out in the country part of everyday police work, huh?
You might say it is today.
And what is that showing for? Are we going on a scavenger hunt, or are we digging for buried treasure, maybe?
You'll find out soon enough.
Morgan, I've played along far enough. I'm not going any further until you tell me what's going on.
This'll do just fine.
Okay, Lieutenant. What are we doing here?
My father used to own this land. He was going to settle down here after he retired from the force. But that never happened. Some punky pulled over for speeding. Shot him 4 times. 30 years on the force. 30 years. And it was over. Just like that.
Oh. Well, that's all very touching, Lieutenant. But what's that got to do with me?
Shut up and listen. I'm not through yet.
My father was a good man. A very good man. He spent his life upholding the law and teaching me to do the same thing. The difference between right and wrong is a very thin line he used to say to me. Then one time, about 25 years ago, he crossed over that line. There was about 10 killings in 2 weeks. The Midnight Strangler, they called him. My father knew who it was, and he caught him. But the courts let him go on a technicality. And the killing started all over again. And a few weeks later, the man disappeared. My father never talked about it, but I knew what he did. I knew what happened.
What the hell are you trying to say?
What I'm saying, Miss Johnson, is today I'm crossing that line.
You're crazy, Morgan. You are out of your mind.
I'm crazy. You killed 12 people, maybe more. And you can stand there and say that I'm crazy?
I didn't kill those people. I killed Jimmy Halleck out of self-defense, and that's all. Read the newspapers.
Oh, I've read the papers. I've heard the reports. And I know the department's position. Rhonda Johnson kills crazed murder and self-defense. The whole damn city's convinced that you're their big hero. I don't know how you set it up like that. I really don't. Maybe you didn't. Maybe you're just damn lucky that another crazy came along and bailed you out just in time. I'm not convinced. I know you did it.
You are wrong, Morgan. You are wrong and you're crazy. You couldn't solve the crime, so your damn hotshot cop ego couldn't swallow it.
I know you did it. You know you did it. If I let you go free now, you'll do it again. I can't let that happen.
You're out of your mind. You can't just bring me up here and kill me. You can't do it. What do you think you are, some self-appointed avenger with a mission from God?
No. Just a man. Justice must be served. The time is now. Somehow I know my father will understand.
I didn't expect to see you today.
I can't say. I just came by to pick up my extra set of keys and then I'm gonna run.
Okay, just listen to this. 2-for-1 special. Purchase your membership this week and 2 join for the price of 1. First 50 new members receive a brand new aerobic outfit. What do you think? Full page ad?
I think it sounds great. Look, why don't you run it over to the newspaper so we don't miss the deadline?
I'm on my way. And by midweek, this place will be packed to the walls with gorgeous bodies.
I'm counting on it.
Mm-hmm.